What's going on YouTube? Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be taking a look at my Christmas streaming setup. Now if you saw my last video, you'll know that I did a complete setup revamp and did a whole themed background for my Twitch streams. So I want to take an in-depth look today at every single item in that setup and how it all works. Now if you want to stop by the Twitch streams and see my setup live, you can check out my Twitch channel, which is linked in the description. And here on YouTube, I'm actually trying to hit 50,000 subs by Christmas morning, and right now we are at 48,430. So if you enjoy this video, don't forget to subscribe. Without further ado, let's go take a look at the setup. So here is the setup from the back. First off, I just want to give a huge apology to all the TechSource fans for this cable management. I know it's hard to look at, so we're just going to skip right past it and come along to the front of the setup. Here you can see all of the new backgrounds for the stream, but I'm going to save that just for a minute and focus on the main parts of my setup. First off, I want to talk about the PC because I did just get a massive upgrade for the PC. My case is the Li & Li O11 Dynamic Mini in Snow White. I have a nice little Kilowa sticker right here that I got from Amazon, and my graphics card is a white 3070. Now I have a custom backplate on it from V1 Tech, and this is hooked up to IQ, so I have that nice glow running through it. And my CPU is what I just upgraded. So I got a Ryzen 9 5900X in here to pair with a 3070. They work together super, super well. I get a steady 240 FPS now in every single game while I'm streaming, so it's really, really nice. I also have a custom backplate on the CPU cooler, which is from V1 Tech as well. And the CPU cooler itself is the H150i or H100i, one of those. It's the one with the 360mm AIO. I know I have a bottom mounted AIO. I know it's not the most optimal position, but I can't top mount it because of that bar on my motherboard. So this is my temporary solution until I get a 240mm AIO later. As for the motherboard itself, it is a B550. And then with that, I have 6 Corsair LL120 fans. And then obviously the Corsair fans that came with the AIO. I have some white cable extensions on the GPU and the motherboard to kind of match the theme of the build. And I think this whole build looks really, really nice together, and everything complements each other super, super well. This is pretty much my in-game PC build. I don't really have anything I want to upgrade in here besides the AIO because now I have a really good combination of CPU and GPU. Moving on from the PC, I'll mention the monitors real quick. This is an Alienware 240Hz, 1 millisecond response time, IPS panel, 1080p monitor. Really, really nice monitor. Never had any complaints with that. On the side right here, I have a Viotech 27-inch 75Hz curved monitor. This one is just used for my OBS, reading chat, my alerts, my stream preview, all that. So don't really worry about the quality too much. On top, I have an Alzai 24-inch flat monitor. This is also 75Hz. Might be 60Hz actually, not positive. But this one just has my Discord and my Spotify on it while I stream. So again, not super important. For stream lighting, I have an Elgato Keylight, which is brand new. I really love this thing. It works really well with my Stream Deck because I can just press a button, turn it off, press a button, turn it on. I can fix all the brightness and stuff on my PC. And this gives really, really good lighting for stream. Now to pair with that, I have this ring light that I got from Amazon. I don't remember which brand it was, but I'll try to link it in the description if I remember. This ring light works really well to complement the other side of my face because this one obviously only gets the left side when I'm sitting right here. And overall, my stream lighting looks really, really good when my camera sits right there on that little mount. For the peripherals, I have a custom keyboard. This entire build is from Drop. It features the Drop Corinna case with Drop MT3 black on white keycaps. Really nice. I have some Laser Mito Cyan switches in here, and I have a nice kind of gradient colorway going through the keyboard. Looks really, really cool. For the mouse, I have a G-Pro Superlight in white, and I have these grip tapes on the side with some Tiger Ice Feet on bottom, so it's totally decked out, customized G-Pro Superlight. I also have the puck removed from here so that it weighs a little bit less. This is a really nice mouse, never had any problems with that either. The mousepad is from GutsyAiden.com. I have a ton of Gutsy Aiden mouse pads. It's like the only brand that I use. A lot of these are Gutsy Aiden pads. Genuinely just a really great company. I switch out these mouse pads all the time for his new ones, but this goes really well with the Christmas theme and looks really nice on my hand cam. For my hand cam, I have a Logitech C922. I think it's like basically the same as the C920. I'm not sure what's different about it, but it's just my hand cam, so I wasn't ever too worried about the quality for it. It just has to look decent. And for my actual camera, I'm using it to record right now, but it is a Canon M50 Mark II, and I'm throwing on a Sigma 16mm f1.4 lens. Looks really nice, has a lot of background blur, all that good stuff. This is a Stream Deck. Everyone knows what this is. Just has a lot of important keybinds for me to switch scenes and stuff while I'm live. This clock is from Amazon. I'll have this linked in the description as well. A lot of you guys are really interested in that clock. This globe is also from Amazon. I'll link that in the description. I'll have an entire list of basically everything that I mentioned in the description, so if you have any questions, check there before commenting. For my audio setup, I have the Shure MV7 microphone with a Blue Compass boom arm, and I wrapped this boom arm in string lights because you can see it on my camera angle right here, so I wanted this to be part of the Christmas revamp. I have a GoXLR plugged into this thing. My GoXLR sits right here on my desk. Really useful for kind of measuring my audio volumes on stream, making sure my mic sounds nice and crispy. For my headset, I use the SteelSeries Arctis 7 wireless with some replacement ear cuffs that are a little bit bigger. These are from Wicked Cushions. I'll link their website in the description. I do actually have some Arctis Pros right there on the ground that I don't really use because those are wired, and I kind of prefer the wireless feel on these. It's just a lot more comfortable for me. The desk itself is from IKEA. This desktop is the IKEA Ek Backen, and these two drawers right here are IKEA Alex drawers. I'm sure you've seen this desk setup before. It's pretty popular. And then I just have some furniture risers right here to kind of separate it and give me some space. I use this side for storage on my Xbox One S, which I have wrapped in this kind of marble skin. Looks really nice. And then over there, I just have a lot of cords hidden under there. That's like the only cable management in my setup, but you know, it helps a little bit over there. Right here under the desk, I have my Xbox Elite Series 1 controller. I only really use this on Fortnite every once in a while when I want to mess around. I don't play that much Fortnite anymore, and I barely ever play controller, but it's nice to have. I basically just used it a lot when I played console a few years ago, so I've kept it all this time. But now I think we've covered everything on this side, so we can safely move on to the stream background, which I'm sure is why a lot of you guys clicked on this video. Starting with this wall, I have some nano leaves in the middle on this nice Christmas pattern, and then a cloud wall all around the outsides. This is basically just foam put on here. I actually used fake snow from Hobby Lobby, but you can just use any kind of foam or cotton, and then it has LED strips underneath it. You can see this line really defined well on camera, but on stream it looks a lot more blurred and like the light is all through the clouds, so it looks a lot better. Moving on to this wall though, the first thing you notice is the galaxy projector. Again, this looks a lot better on stream with some background blur. It looks a lot less defined. And I think it just looks really cool, fits the Christmas scheme pretty well. I have some string lights going all the way up here and then draping down and around all the way down here. Again, just kind of fits the Christmas scheme, adds something to this otherwise really big blank area. I have this Christmas bow right here, just a really big present bow I got for like a dollar from Hobby Lobby. It's just taped to my window. I think it just fills up some space. This is my Christmas tree. This fits really well with the Christmas theme, obviously. And this is actually pretty cool because it ties directly into my Twitch streams. All of these ornaments that you see have the names of viewers who have gifted 5 subs on my Twitch channel. It's a really cool way to just kind of incorporate viewers into the stream and kind of give those big supporters a chance to have something special. Now the cool thing is that at the end of the month, every one of these ornaments is going to get entered into a giveaway to win this keyboard right here. It's a SteelSeries Apex Pro TKL. It's around a $200 keyboard, and I'm super excited for this giveaway. It's going to be a lot of fun. Moving on to this desk over here, I have some candy that I was munching on stream. We're going to ignore that for now. The desk itself is a Linmon tabletop from IKEA, really good budget tabletop. And then I have this desk leg from FlexiSpot. It's a rising, like, sit-stand, height-adjustable desk, which means it was really easy to get it perfectly lined up with this desk. I'm pretty happy about that. These are two Christmas trees that I have. They both show in the stream background, just look pretty cool. And then right here is the snowman. In my last video, I told everybody that the top comment would get to name this snowman, and y'all chose Philip. Something about the name Philip just really, really was appealing to y'all. So here's Philip. This is some G Fuel from stream earlier, snow cone flavored, the best flavor I've ever tried out of like the 20 flavors that I've tried. Like probably 6 or 7 of these tubs are just snow cone because I keep running out. Now hiding behind all of this, I actually have a floodlight. This kind of carries my entire stream background because it makes this whole wall look blue instead of gray. I have another floodlight right here to make the wall behind me look blue. And just to show you guys the difference that these make, I'm going to turn this one off and turn that one off. And look at how boring the background is now. It looks so much worse. Just turn this back on and boom, looks a lot more festive. Then over here, you can kind of see the difference in without it and then with it. Kind of transforms this whole background, makes it have more of a winter theme. Super, super easy way to make your stream background look 10 times better if you're on a budget. This chair is the Autonomous Ergo Chair 2. I get a ton of questions about this chair and whether or not I recommend it, and honestly, I can't say I do. The bottom gets really, really hot because there's like no breathability to it, and it's really not that great for my back. My back hurts pretty bad after sitting in this for like 5 or 6 hours on stream. Planning on getting a new chair soon, and this one will probably go in my room to be my editing setup, but yeah, just to kind of answer that question once and for all, no, don't get this chair. The last thing I had a question on was actually this, and yeah, I basically just have these boxes stacked up on the bottom for this tree to stand on because when it's sitting on the ground, it's like way too short to be seen on stream. The stream angle is right around here, so if it's any lower, it just like can't be seen at all unless I tilt the camera down, and I don't think that angle looks very good. Again, if you want to stop by the Twitch streams and see all of this in action, the link will be in the description, so I'd really appreciate you stopping by there. And be sure to subscribe to help me hit 50k by Christmas. But that's gonna wrap up this video, so I'll see you guys next time.